We're good?
Okay.
Ready to start. Oh, it's rolling. All right, we got fireworks coming up. It's like a couple of days before, well, yeah, date the video right off the start. Good idea. I did a video a while ago. I'll link to it up above. So I kind of talked about my, you know, basically how to photograph fireworks. Got a lot of views. I just watched it. I recorded it like 6 years ago, maybe 8 years ago. It's awful. I'm on the patio. The air conditioner is out there on the building next. You can't hear. I did offer some pretty good tips. I think what I'm gonna do is redo that video here in the studio. You'll actually be able to hear what I'm saying, and I'll bang through them really quick. And between those ideas and suggestions and tips, I'll share a firework image from last year. I think. So let's get into it, shall we? All right, so I'll assume that we wanna get really good images here or try to get something better than you will with your iPhone. You're gonna see people out there with the iPads and the Galaxies and the phones and all that. They take pretty good images. They don't take really good, crisp, low noise still images. So that's why we have a DSLR, could be a mirrorless. I happen to have the Nikon D800 with me here on the sticks. So that's really my first tip is the sticks. The sticks are a tripod, in other words. Fancy name for it for us photog peeps. And a lens, I recommend a zoom lens. I'll talk about that in a couple of minutes, but I have right on here a 28 to 300. Last time I went out shooting with this Nikon, I think I used a 24 to 70. But anyway, something that gives you a little bit of zoom range and something you can set into manual, which we'll talk about in a minute. And of course, the pair of sticks. And I'll share some images like this one. Okay, so we're gonna take a couple of minutes to talk about this next tip, and that is really to set everything into manual. Starting with the lens, we wanna be in manual. We don't want that thing searching for focus in the dark, trying to chase that firework when it goes up. We wanna kinda be focused out to infinity. What I usually do, I take it out to infinity, which is that little ampersand symbol, and what I do then is back it off of that. From my experience, if you're fully at infinity, it's a little bit blurry, so I kinda back off of that. If there's a building there, you could focus on the edge of a building and then take it into manual focus. Again, we're going all manual on the camera here. We don't want to be an auto ISO. Set your ISO nice and low, 100 or 200. We don't want this image to be noisy. We want to shoot in raw. As far as the white balance, I would start out at, I believe, daylight or 5,000. Again, you're shooting in raw. You should be able to adjust that pretty easily in Lightroom or Photoshop or Bridge, or, you know, whatever you're processing in. You don't process in Bridge. You know what I'm saying. So daylight balance or auto white balance. As far as the exposure, you want to be in manual, and I would set the f-stop at like around, I'd start with f11, maybe f16. Now what that's going to enable you to do is hold the shutter open longer. If you were at f2.8 and you held the shutter open long enough to get those nice trails, you'd get a big blown out, ugly, washed out image. So you want to be at, like I said, around f11, f16, and then have your shutter set to bulb. That's probably the most important thing. Since you're on a tripod, you're not moving the camera, you're focused out to infinity, my recommendation, again, you're gonna vary this up, you're gonna have fun with this, but one of the suggestions is, as you see that firework going up, just before it explodes, you hit that shutter, you hold it open, you see a nice smattering, whatever. Why is it beeping? I guess there's a beeper in here. Anyway, you see that nice spray? Hold it open for 4 or 5 seconds. Look at the LCD. Looks like garbage. Hold it longer. Hold it shorter. Really depends. Once you get into the finale, though, if you hold it open for a long amount of time like that, you're gonna see it's just gonna be nuts. So you're gonna have to vary this. Shoot a couple hundred images. If you want a couple of keepers, you're gonna have to shoot a lot of them just to get enough to choose from. So yeah, I think that's all we have there as far as camera settings. Remember, manual? Well, remember everything I said. I'll put notes below. And check out this shot. Oh yeah, let me pause for a thumbnail before I forget. Should I hold it like this? Yeah. So the third tip that I wrote down was to shoot in RAW. And I think I already told you that, but I guess, you know, why are we shooting in RAW? Well, the RAW file is like a negative. It gives you a lot more leeway. It gives you the opportunity to drag those shadows up or raise the shadows, take the highlights down if they're too bright. It just gives you a lot more flexibility in exposure and color, a lot more than you get if you're just shooting JPEG. So again, third tip, I would shoot in RAW. And check out this shot. Can you tell this camera moved? I tripped over the tripod. Again, I think I already talked about my fourth tip, and that is to use a shutter release. Again, experiment with the amount of time that you hold that shutter open. If you don't have a shutter release, you can also set your camera to like 10 seconds or 5 seconds and use the timer, like a 2 second timer. So you're not touching the camera and touching the shutter button. So I just use the remote because it's a little more, I don't know, efficient, hands-on, organic. So check out this shot. All right, so my fifth and final tip would be to find something other than the fireworks to photograph. What do I mean by that? Down where I photograph for our 4th of July, I can go on the other side of the intercoastal and shoot toward the city, get the skyline in the shot. Gives the fireworks a little bit more story. There's a little bit more of a scene, I think, if you have a skyline. Maybe you have some boats in the foreground, some water. You can get on the edge of the bridge, catch some of the bridge in the shot. Maybe you're near buildings, you can get some reflections off of the building. Maybe you get some of the reflections and some of the fireworks. Getting down low, shooting through trees. There's a lot of ways to compose this. I wouldn't go for too many because the fireworks go pretty quick. You don't want to be jostling around for a position. So maybe where you're at, scope out a nice place, pick out a cut. You know, this is great tips for me, actually. I'm probably gonna go over to Palm Beach. There's a bike trail there. It's usually slow this time of year. Hopefully I'll be able to stake out a couple of locations, maybe a dock, maybe a palm tree. And you know, while we're talking about, you know, thinking outside of the box here, don't forget when the fireworks are going off here, they're creating light and lighting what's back here. And what's usually back here are people. So you may wanna take the camera off the tripod just to get the reaction of people. And another reason I use the zoom lens is not only because I'm not sure where I'm going to be and what I'm going to wanna capture and how far the fireworks are gonna be away. Another creative idea is while you're shooting or while you're exposing, while the shutter's open, is to slightly move. Say we're set at 50 millimeter, hit that shutter, and while that's open, you change it to 70 and let go. You'll get a little bit of zoom, you know, light trail thing coming at you. I don't know, just an idea. It's a lot of things you could do. Maybe you could take and hand hold for a couple of these, keep the shutter open and move the camera around. Yeah, there's a lot of ideas, you know, just get creative. But again, if you want to if you really want to make sure and nail the shot, I'd start with the basic settings and then start experimenting from there. Make sure and shoot a lot again. And one final thing, don't be afraid to layer some of these firework shots over top of each other in post. In Photoshop as layers, create your own finale. So anyway, enjoy this image right here. All right, so this is the time in these videos where I do a channel of the week. And I think this week it's gonna have to be Matt Koskowski, or Matt, M-A-T-T-K.com, I believe. He used to work for Kelby One, or Kelby Training, or Scott Kelby, and he was a teacher. He still is a teacher. He's a great teacher. He's a great photographer, family guy, lives in Tampa, I believe. I remember a couple of years ago when I actually forgot how to shoot fireworks, even though I did my own video that has over 5,000 views. I looked at his website and he had some quick tips on there. He's a great teacher, has a good YouTube presence. I think I'll share his YouTube channel here and his website in the description below. So check out Matt and his work. He's a great teacher, good Lightroom teacher, and good all-around guy. And that's all I got. Good luck photographing. Let me know if you have any more questions. And as always, more on all this later.